Good morning. Well, this is the first of a series of videos on my little Yanmar marine diesel engine. I find the simplicity of these engines to be compelling, and I think you will too. Today it's time for an oil change, so why don't you come along? Now, you always start an oil change by running the engine for at least a few minutes for two reasons. Can you tell me why? I'll give you the first answer. Solid contaminants tend to sit at the bottom of the pan, and you stand a greater chance of removing that sludge if the oil is hot and recently circulating. But there's another reason, and perhaps it's even better than that. Watch this video and tell me the answer. Now remember that there are no spark plugs in a diesel, and so turning the engine off is not an electrical procedure. Right now I'm pressing on the mechanical kill switch, which cuts off fuel supply to the fuel injectors, switching the engine off.
Well, what I find most intriguing about these engines is their elegant simplicity. Up here is your raw water reservoir and the coolant, the freshwater coolant antifreeze reservoir. We put antifreeze in here and oil in here. And this here is the air filter. Now, in a gasoline engine, controlling idle rate is all about controlling air. But in the diesel, it's reversed. Controlling idle is all about controlling fuel. And air is allowed free intake to what would have been the throttle body and carburetor. So there's no throttle body, no carburetor. And down here is the oil filter, and find an appropriate size wrench and spin it off. You want to get something underneath to prevent it from dripping. So one of the most important things you can do when you change an oil filter is to make sure that this rubber gasket here comes off when you take the oil filter off. There it is right there. And you can see that rubber gasket's come right off. Double check this surface where you took it off to make sure it's nice and clean. And then you just take a dab of oil and you coat that. Now, a lot of people know this trick, but many don't know why. And the reason you do this is so that when you spin the new filter on, it slides rather than grabbing the gasket. And if it were to grab the gasket, it could pull it out of round and create a leak where you don't want a leak. So lubricate the edge. Now, the other thing that's convenient to do in some engines is to fill it with fresh oil. And you can do that, but if you notice here, this filter is mounted sideways, and so we're not going to get very much oil into the filter if you do that, and I don't want to make a mess. And so we're not going to do that this time, but bear that in mind if you have a filter that's mounted vertically. So we'll just put it on and spin it on. It goes on hand tight. You don't need a wrench to put it on. And you go about 3/4 of a turn after it's hand tight. There we are.
Well, one of the most important elements of boat stability is to have the heaviest elements, like the engine, as low as possible. That design is in conflict with the usual oil change method of sliding a tray underneath and draining oil from a pan bolt. So many small boat engines don't have a drain plug at the bottom, and if they do, it's very hard to reach. Some have a petcock you can attach a plastic tube to, and you can suck oil out that way. But the usual method in these Yanmar engines is to use a suction tube slid through the oil dipstick hole. The dipstick hole is back there.
Of course, in a boat, there's never enough access. This is a side panel here, and we're going to take the engine oil dipstick out. That's this right here. And then we're going to siphon that old oil out that hole. This is the largest tube that will fit down the siphon hole, so now I'm going to slide it down into the siphon hole and get to a point where I can suction the fluid out. Of course, nobody has any misconceptions that this procedure will get all of the oiled oil out, which means that you generally replace oil more frequently in a boat engine than you do in a regular automobile engine. Uh, I pulled the tube back a bit and I'm getting a bit more, and so evidently the tip of the tube is curled up in the oil pan. Right now we're about 2.5 liters, which is about the capacity of this engine. And now I'm holding it up so I can get some of the tubing drained. Now, the devil's in the details when it comes to doing a job like this. Make sure you put the new oil in. Most of us have specialized devices like this funnel that I use to... It's got a nice low profile so that when I pour the oil in, I'm not going to have trouble with the inadequate access above. And of course, take a paper towel and wipe off all of the peripheral devices and also the inside of the old funnel to make sure you're not going to be pouring any impurities back into the engine. Put in about what you took off. In this case, about 2.5 liters. Now, you want it to be on the high side of normal, but you don't want it to be overfilled, because if you end up overfilling, you'll end up with the problem of frothing of the oil and then a problem with your seals later. So high side of normal, but not above the upper limits. Now, at this point, we need to rerun the engine to try and get rid of some of the air bubbles, in particular, the air bubble in the oil filter. And so I'm going to turn the engine on for a few minutes. I'm going to check for leaks and make sure there are no other problems, and then recheck my levels. Now, I think it's very important to have the engine running right after you do an oil change. That allows the oil to get back up into the upper areas and recirculate, whereas if you have air bubbles when you start it the next time, it'll be a little slower at getting the oil into the upper part of the engine, and so there's extra engine wear that you're going to be facing if you don't run the engine right away. Because we had the engine running just a few minutes ago, I can be assured that during that gap when you don't have very good oil pressure while the oil filter is being filled with fluid, you still have good lubrication up top. Now, the second thing you're doing is you're looking for oil leaks down underneath near the air filter or the oil filter, and you're looking to see you haven't left anything stupid behind, like a rag or a light or some other thing. You haven't left the oil cap off. Look for stupid mistakes, because those are the most common and the most embarrassing. Say, if this video helped you out, then hit like or subscribe or leave a comment. I'd love to hear what others say. Thanks for watching.